Hi, Scorpio. This is Eileen with your August 2018 Psychic Tarot Card Reading. And we're starting the month of August with the Queen of Wands card. And the wands do relate to the fire signs of Aries, Leo, and Sagittarius. And wands also relate to work, matters of work, and action, progress, moving forward. But what I'm getting here, now I am tuning in on a psychic level as well as reading the meanings of the cards. But this Queen of Wands figure might be in some of your lives during the month of August, Scorpio. So you may have someone around you like this at work. It might be someone in the way of a personal relationship. Some of you might even be embodying the traits of the Queen of Wands in August, where you're just working hard and wanting to get things done, feeling good that you know you've already accomplished a certain amount and feeling good about your life and feeling confident and strong, but that you still have a lot of work to do. And also, the Queen of Wands can be a very compassionate person and a nice person on the one hand, but then on the other hand can get impatient or short-tempered, that sort of thing, because this does relate to a fire sign. So for some of you, you might have someone like this around you, maybe in the workplace. I'm getting for some, I feel like now for, if you're a male watching the video, I'm feeling like for one of you or maybe more than one, this Queen of Wands figure, it represents a female that's going to be around you. And I feel like she has a good job. She's very intelligent and well-spoken. And I feel like she's probably fairly attractive also. I'm feeling like she's probably within a few years or several years of your age. But I do feel there's some romantic interest here. And she feels like she has been in a serious relationship in the past, but now she's looking for someone else. She's out of that relationship or getting out of it or whatever. So she might be kind of looking at you like she's, maybe this is someone you'll be getting to know. It might be somebody you know already. Possibly in the workplace, possibly from someplace else, maybe around where you live or something. I'm not sure. Yeah, so I am getting some romantic feelings for, this might just be for one person I'm tuning into. It might be for a few. And then for others of you, you might have this Queen of Wands figure around you in the workplace. This might represent someone you work for. It might be a manager or something where you work. I'm feeling like she can be very helpful to you. If this, for anyone of you Scorpios that are listening to the video, if this Queen of Wands figure sounds like someone that might be like a manager or something that you work under in your job, I'm feeling like she could be helpful to you. That's what I'm feeling like. I don't know if you're fairly new at your job or have just started working in that particular department where she is, anything like that. But I'm feeling she can be very helpful to you and very beneficial. Yeah, and it also, this could be someone who offers you a job. You might be applying for a new job, and she might be the one, the manager or whatever, that interviews you or decides to hire you. I'm just feeling she can be helpful to some, maybe a few people I'm tuning in for. I'm not sure. Because there's different scenarios for different people. This is a general reading, so some things will apply to certain people, and others will apply to other people. Let's see, the next card we have is the Page of Wands. And again, the wands relating to the fire signs of Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. And the Page of Wands is talking about some kind of good news coming your way. So for some, and it could be work-related since the wands do relate to work matters. So some of you, you might be finding out that you're being offered a new job. You may have just applied for a job. You might be applying in the month of August. And you might be finding out that you're the one they're offering the job to. Let me see what else I'm getting here. And sometimes this news can come kind of quickly. So for some of you that you've been waiting on particular news about work or money or anything like that, about taking action on a particular project, you might, the news just might come your way. You know, you might not have to wait too long. You might get some good news coming up soon because it does relate to good news. Now, also, I am feeling, since I'm getting different scenarios for different people here, that the Page of Wands does represent, the pages do represent someone in the younger age group, maybe in their 20s or something. I am feeling like for someone, this might be one person or a few people this relates to, that this Page of Wands is someone that would be around you and be just getting to know you, like interested into getting to know you better. It might start out kind of like friendship. This could be somebody like if you're in school or something, taking classes, it could be like a classmate or something. Or it could be in the work area. I'm just feeling for some of you, this is somebody new coming into your life. And this page of the page also could, this could represent a male or a female. I mean, everybody's got a certain amount of male and female energy, but I'm getting different scenarios for different people. So I am feeling like, especially like if you're in that age bracket or maybe in your 20s or something, that you might be around someone new who would really is a very, I feel like this person's honest and down to earth and just a good quality person. And they're going to be around you and wanting to get to know you. And I feel like it's more than, it starts out friendship, but it's more than just friendship that they're interested in you for. So be on the lookout. Okay, and then the next card we have is the Knight of Cups. And the Cups now, of course, relating to the water signs of Pisces, Scorpio, and Cancer. And so the Knight of Cups, this is talking about possible proposals of love or marriage for some of you. Yeah, I'm getting I'm getting a lot of good energy from this card. I do feel like someone of you Scorpios that watched the video, you're already engaged or you're getting engaged in the month of August. Because I feel like Knight of Cups is representing someone that you've already been seeing and they're coming forward with a proposal of marriage or just to really confirm their love for you, even if it's, I don't know, I'm getting proposals. I think somebody's going to be getting engaged in August or thereabouts, maybe soon after. Maybe they're just expressing their feelings in a really positive, strong, proactive way that leads to an engagement or something like that, some other commitment coming up in the near future, in the next couple of months or something. Because I am feeling for someone of you Scorpios that see the video that this person is, that you've already been seeing them. And it may not have been all that long that you've been involved with this person for that matter. I am getting different scenarios. I think this is for different people here. For some, maybe for one or a few of you, you might just be meeting the right person for you in the month of August. For others, you've already been seeing this person either for a few months, possibly for a number of months. But I'm getting something about new relationships of love. And it does, it just feels good. It feels like a number of you might just be have already just met the right person for you, or you will be meeting the right person for you in the month of August, or maybe just thereabouts. So now also this Knight of Cups, it does have another meaning that for people who work in an artistic field, you might be having an offer of work if you're an artist of some type. But I'm getting a lot of romance around this card. I'm getting love, commitments of love, romance, possible marriage, or just someone exclaiming their love for you in one way or another. I'm just getting some good, a lot of good energy, different scenarios for different people there. Okay, let's see. And again, this is a general reading, so everyone isn't going to have these particular, some people will resonate with one part of the reading, other people will resonate with other parts of the reading. If it was a private reading, then I would be honing in just on that person's circumstances. The next card we have is the Six of Wands. And the Wands, we're back with the Wands, back to having to do with the fire signs of Aries, Leo, and Sagittarius. So, and again, work-related matters. So a number of you Scorpios may be getting a certain amount of recognition in the month of August for all the work that you've been doing, for your accomplishments, and you're feeling confident and feeling positive that you've been really making progress in your life, progress in your work, and you're feeling good about that, and you're being recognized by other people for the good progress that you've been making. So just some overall good feelings and good energy for a number of you in your work area, whether you or some of you may be self-employed, others might be working for a company, or maybe there's been a big project that you've been working on of one kind or another, and you know you're making progress. So you're feeling good. You know you still have further to go, but you're making progress. And you know, feeling positive, feeling confident, like you know you're going to be continuing forward and making even more progress. So this is really good. I'm getting a strong feeling with this card here in the area of work and making money and accomplishing your goals and things like that. So a number of you Scorpios will be feeling fairly good in the month of August over your current accomplishments and just making that progress you want in your life. And then let's see, the next card, we have another page of cups. And again, the cups relating to the water signs of Pisces, Scorpio, or Cancer. So this page, and again, this is having to do with love and feelings and good news of relating to, again, maybe engagements or marriage or something romantic, someone professing their love for you. So we're getting quite a bit of that with these cups, and just, I don't know, I'm just getting a lot of good energy around here for some of you anyway that are going to be doing well in that department. Again, it's a general reading. Everything is not going to apply to each person, but a number of you will be enjoying the benefits of romance and love in your life with someone who's a really good match for you. And so again, the Page of Cups, and you might even be hearing good news about someone having a baby or getting pregnant or getting married, getting engaged, whatever. And you could be the recipient of any of those things as well, if that would be something happy, causing you some happiness too. So, so overall, it's a nice light, upbeat feeling I'm getting with this Page of Cups. But again, I'm getting the pages, typically it might be somebody in their 20s or something. I'm once again feeling like whoever you are, Scorpios, that you might be in that age bracket, maybe in your 20s. Again, this represents also for some of you a new romantic partner who steps into your life, and they might be another water sign. Maybe they're a Scorpio, maybe they're a Pisces or a Cancer, or have a lot of water in their chart if that's not their sign. And I feel like, once again, I'm not getting, just like with this page, I don't get someone who's attracted to you and being pushy about it, trying to push themselves. Instead, they're just being kind of low-key and pleasant and nice and just wanting to get to know you as a as an acquaintance and then as a friend, and just see if it's going to develop, like if there would be something there. It's like they're initially attracted to you or find you interesting or intelligent and attractive and whatever, and they want to see if more might come of it, but they're not jumping to conclusions, which is good. It's good to make sure you like somebody as a person and you have enough common interest and your philosophies about life and whatever, and develop a real friendship before going on to romance, because then you'd have a stronger relationship anyway. So yeah, a lot of good energy for a number of you Scorpios in August. We're in the romance department, love and romance, you know, finding the right one or meeting the right one, already being with the right one for you. So again, it's not everybody won't experience this, but it's the energy is there for a number of you Scorpios in August. Okay, and then the next card we have is the Moon card. And this is a major arcana destiny card, the Moon. And the light of the Moon does not illuminate everything clearly. So there may be some things that are hidden from view in the month of August. So the Moon is a cautionary card to use your intuition, as your intuition will be sharper in the month of August anyway. And Scorpios are pretty intuitive as it is, but your intuition might be even stronger in the month of August. And according to this moon card, you need it, because there may be things under the surface that are not being shown to you. And this could be in the romantic area. It could be in other relationships. It could be with family, friends, romantic partners. It could even be in some business matters that you're dealing with, or money matters. So the advice here is to dig deeper. Don't just take things at surface value. Don't just believe what someone tells you the situation is. If it's something important to you, whether it's a relationship or a business transaction, if you're making a big purchase of some kind, dig deeper, do your research, listen to your intuition. Everything could look and sound real good on the surface, but if you get some uncomfortable feeling under your skin, that's your intuition telling you something's not adding up right. And I do feel that some people, I'm getting some personal relationship matters that I feel like there's a different scenarios, but I'm getting some business matters that some of you need to pay close attention to. And if you don't have all the details, stop, back up, really get all of your information before you proceed, so you know exactly what you're walking into. For personal romantic relationships, I'm feeling like this might be one person I'm tuning in for, or a few, that someone's going to be in some kind of relationship where you're being left in the dark in that relationship. It's kind of foggy. You're not being given all the information. Your partner is kind of brushing things off and seeming to be a little, a little disconnected, almost like they want you to take whatever story they're giving you, that's the way it is, but you're not feeling right about it. It's almost like you're looking at this person you're involved with, excuse me, and feeling like they're not giving you the whole story about something going on with them. And your feelings most likely are right. Like I said, use your intuition. If this is you in this situation with a partner, and don't, especially if it's just, normally they're more connected to you and more, just seem to be more open with you. And then all of a sudden they're kind of wanting to brush things off and not be, and make you think you're just imagining things. I mean, listen to your intuition, dig a little deeper to find out what's going on behind the scenes that's not being shown. I got to get a sip of my water. Okay, and then the next card we have is the Seven of Swords. And with the Seven of Swords, you got to be cautious. And again, right next to the moon, where the moon's saying everything's not adding up right for some of you, that you're not getting all the details, you're not getting the whole picture. Seven of Swords is talking about someone possibly cheating you. You know, someone maybe getting away with something. So this is a cautionary card to really pay attention to what's going on. Something may not. Now, also, this card does say to be diplomatic in dealings with others. So it may not just relate to something being taken from you, but you might be having some discussions with someone and they're not going as well as you had hoped, like you both have different opposing views or something. And so if that's the case for some of you, this card cautions you just to be as diplomatic as you can in your handling of that situation. But then I'm getting really big vibes here about someone being dishonest. Okay, I'm getting that much more heavily than just having to negotiate with people better. It's some of you, and maybe more than just some, might be dealing with someone in your life. This could be in business. It could be in a personal relationship. I'm getting different scenarios for different people, that someone's going to be very dishonest with you and wanting to take advantage. And they don't care. This person has no conscience about what they do. They're even a little amused at themselves. So I don't know how many people I'm tuning in for. I think this might be a few different scenarios I'm getting here. I am feeling for some of you, maybe one or more, that it has to do with somebody trying to cheat you somehow or another in something relating to business or money, you know, maybe something you're purchasing or thinking about purchasing, or even someone being sneaky around you and trying to steal something from you. Be careful if you have people you don't know well at your home, maybe to repair something or whatever, you know, just somebody that's normally not around, and all of a sudden you've got somebody that's kind of a stranger or just barely an acquaintance. Keep a watch on things. just exercise those kinds of cautions, because I am getting different scenarios for different people. And again, it's a general reading. Everybody's not going to have this character in their life in August, but some of you will. And then for some, I'm getting it's a relationship matter. It's someone you've already been involved with. I feel like they're on the way out. You already see how they are, okay? But they've cheated you in some way. They've been dishonest. They came across in the beginning like they were real on the up and up and charming and whatever and sincere. And then as you got to know them better, you saw they're not. They lie. They cheat. And they don't care. They don't care. It's just this character, depending on whose scenario it's in, they really don't have much of a conscience. So a number of you Scorpios will be around somebody like that in one way or another. So, but you're very intuitive. You've got the moon here. You've got stronger intuition. But it's interesting that this character shows up alongside the moon, and the moon is saying everything's not like it looks on the surface. Dig deeper. Pay attention. So I think these two cards kind of tie in. But you need to just use your intuition as well as your logical mind in dealing with other people, you know, and protect yourself the best you can. Okay, next card we have is the Three of Pentacles. And the Pentacles card, this is a good card. Pentacles relating to the earth signs of Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. So Pentacles having to do with making money, prosperity. So for a number of you Scorpios, you're going to be busy, doing well at your jobs and whatever line of work. I'm feeling some of you are self-employed and you're doing really good work and people recognize you for that. And even people who work at a company, I feel like you're known to do really good quality work. And people, if you're working at a particular company, I feel like the higher ups, the management, they look at you as a good example of how everybody should be. For those of you that are self-employed, I feel like people will look at you and they see your work as good quality work and feel like you're kind of like the ideal, you know, of someone who's in that particular field, who's doing that particular work, that you really are good at what you do. And so even if they don't even know you that well, whatever they know of you and of the amount of whatever type of work you do, they're impressed. They feel like it's good quality work that you do. And then a lot of you will be feeling good about yourselves because you're doing work you enjoy, that you're really good at. You just have a natural ability for this work that you're doing, and you're making money. You know, you want to make more, but you're seeing the progress and you're patient. You know, you'll just keep working well and working hard, and so you can work towards your goals. You have goals and plans for yourself, and you're pleased. You're pleased with your progress. Yeah, so I get really good energy from this card. For those of you Scorpios who aren't finding, who aren't feeling like you're doing well in your life or making that kind of progress, I would advise you to get in alignment with the laws of attraction and start feeling successful and feeling prosperous and proactive, and start identifying and having the intention of doing well in whatever your chosen field is, whatever projects you're working on, whatever phase of your life that, you know, just get in that frame of mind so you can attract the good things. That really helps the universe to open the doors to bring you prosperous conditions when you already start feeling like you're there and that you're working on improving your life and improving your finances and whatever it is that matters to you. The next card we have is the Empress card. And with the Empress, this is another major arcana, destiny card. And this card, the Empress, is talking about bringing things to fruition. It's combining the earthly matters with spirituality. It's balancing, having balance in your life. It does. Now, this does also relate to pregnancy, a happy family. Some of you might be getting pregnant or already pregnant in the month of August. So it does relate to having a well-balanced life, feeling good about the progress you're making because you're seeing the results of the work that you've done. It does relate to having a happy kind of life, kind of feeling like you've got it going. You've got things the way you want for the most part, even if you know there's still more to do and more to accomplish and you're not finished yet, you know, you still, but you're feeling good about what you have now, how well you've done in your life, in your career. And you know, it's not like anybody's handed you anything. You know, you've worked and been working hard for a long time and you're making plans and setting goals and you feel good about the work you're doing, but you also feel good that you're managing to balance your life fairly well. So you're able to enjoy your free time too and your family and just whatever plans you're making for your life that you want to have balance. You don't want to be a workaholic. You want to have a good, healthy, well-rounded life. But you're enjoying, so a number of you are enjoying the fruits of your labor, you're enjoying your families, your friends, and feeling a certain amount of satisfaction and contentment and just feeling prosperous and feeling confident at the things you've already accomplished. So once again, for those Scorpios who are not in this place, get in touch with the laws of attraction, learn about the laws of attraction, and start to feel that confidence, because this is a confident card here. This is someone who's feeling confident and strong because they know they're very well-rounded. They're looking at the big picture of their life, not just work, not just romance or family or friends. They're looking at having a good balance of all of it, having it all. And they don't mind working. They've already been working to have it all, and they're going to continue to work. And they're proud and pleased at what they've done already. So I would say get lined up with the laws of attraction to bring that lifestyle to yourselves for those of you who are not experiencing some form of that now. Then the last card we have is the Seven of Cups. And with the Seven of Cups, Cups again relating to the water signs, Pisces, Scorpio, Cancer. And the Seven of Cups is talking about being a little dreamy, having choices, having a lot of choices to make, not sure what choice to make. For some of you, you might be thinking about what you want to do in your careers. For others, since the cups do relate to love and romance, you might be trying to figure out, well, who would be the right person for you? You might have a few different people around you, and you don't know who might be your right mate or if you've even met the right person yet. So sometimes it's a card of illusion, of being a little too dreamy. Yeah, I think for some of you, you might feel by the end of August, you might be kind of disconnecting a little bit and just, I don't know. And you know, I feel like sometime if you do that anyway, maybe your mind needs to disconnect. Sometime you need a break because maybe you have been doing a lot of work and focusing and really driving yourself and staying busy and taking care of all your responsibilities. And sometime you just want to disconnect a little bit and be a little dreamy. So I don't think it's a bad thing, but and it's just overall your reading is really good, but it does talk about having choices. I think part of the advice of this card is to look at your situation objectively and realistically before making any choices so that you're not, you know, being unrealistic with whatever choices you make, whether it's in the romance department or some other area of your life. And since it is cups, it could relate to relationships and romance and that sort of thing. But sometime I feel like for some of you, you might just be thinking about your life in general. I mean, do you want to move? I feel like some of you might be thinking, do I want to move and just relocate to another state or whatever? I'm getting a certain amount of that type of thinking for some of you, and being a little carried away where you're not really looking at all the details that would be involved and all the pros and cons. So I think it's really analyzing, if you are trying to make a choice, try to analyze all the pros and cons about it, as well as listening to your intuition. Yeah, so, but otherwise, you know, it's good to have a little escape here and there where you can be a little dreamy. I don't think there's anything wrong with that myself. Okay, now, this deck, this is the Gilded Tarot by Ciro Marchetti that I've been using. And what I want to do now is I'm going to pull one card from the Fairy Tarot cards by Doreen Virtue and Radleigh Valentine. Okay, so I'm going to shuffle these. So I need, what is the message for Scorpio for the month of August? What's the message for Scorpio? If you like my videos, be sure and subscribe to my channel so you'll be notified when I post new videos. If you have subscribed already, I thank you for your subscriptions. And feel free to leave your comments. I welcome your comments. And be sure and check for your rising and moon signs as they come available. Actually, my moon sign is Scorpio. Mine's Aries with Scorpio. Scorpio moon, and I'm on the cusp of Pisces. But anyway, and so, yeah, feel free to leave your comments. And if anyone would like a private reading, my rates and contact info are listed below. Okay, so I need one card with a message for Scorpio for August 2018. What's the message for Scorpio for August 2018? Scorpio, August 2018. Okay, I'm going to fan these out and pick one card. I think it's this one. This one's kind of looking at me here. Okay. This says Queen of Summer, loving, comforting, emotional, intuitive. Listen to your heart. Wait, let me see if I can get that in where it's not blurry or something. Listen to your heart, intuitive insights you can trust. Taking care of others, perhaps too much. In other words, make sure you're caring for yourself as well. Queen of Summer. This might relate to the Queen of Hearts. I'm not sure. Loving, comforting, emotional, intuitive. Yeah, this reminds me of the traits of the Queen of Cups, which relates, again, to the water signs, which you are. Okay, but that's a good message. Listen to your heart, intuitive insights you can trust. Taking care of others, perhaps too much. Okay, let's see. And that ties in with your intuition being stronger in the month of August anyway. And all these, I don't know, you've got a lot of cards having to do with love and feelings and emotions. Now I'm going to pick one card from Nature's Whispers by Angela Hartfield with artwork by Josephine Wall. Okay, so what's the message for Scorpio for the month of August 2018 for Scorpio? What's the message for Scorpio for August 2018? Scorpio for August 2018. One more shuffle and then I'll fan the cards out. Okay, so what's the message for Scorpio for August 2018? I think it's this one here. I like this. Okay, this says be true to your heart. That's number 26. Be true to your heart. I love the imagery in these cards. So beautiful. There's so much gorgeous detail in these cards. I mean, the more you look at them, the more images you find in them. Okay, I'm going to read this one in the booklet. Be true to your heart, number 26. Let me look this one up. I like the sound of it already, though. Okay, let's see. Number 26. Be true to your heart. In this moment, draw on the energies of harmony and union when making a choice. The current situation is best supported using intuition and not intellect. There may be difficult decisions to be made that are not necessarily about love. Consciously be aware of what interests you, what attracts your attention, what stirs your imagination and creates passion in your life. Do your best to ignore the persuasion of what others might think or say. Trust yourself and don't allow your opinion to be swayed. That is fantastic advice. I love that card. I love it. I love the message. That's a really good message. Okay, and then last but not least, I'm picking one card from Messages from Your Angels by Doreen Virtue. Okay, so what's the message for Scorpio for August 2018? For Scorpio, what's the message? What's the message for Scorpio for August 2018? Scorpio. Okay. I'm going to fan them out again. Okay, I think it's this one here. Okay, this says Angel Merlina. Like Merlin the magician, Merlina. You are confused and indecisive because you do not have enough information. Do research or seek expert advice before making a decision. That ties in with the moon card again. And being more, digging a little deeper, using your intuition. Merlina, you are confused and indecisive because you do not have enough information. Do research or seek expert advice before making a decision. Yeah, that definitely ties in with this one, the moon, and even possibly the Seven of Cups card, too many choices, not knowing which way to go. But anyway, okay, so I think you have some good messages here for August, a lot of good cards. And I hope you've enjoyed the video, Scorpio. Be sure and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so yet, so you'll be notified as I post new videos. If you have subscribed, I thank you for your subscriptions. And be sure and check for your rising and moon signs as they come available. Feel free to leave your comments. I welcome your comments. And if anyone would like a private reading, my rates and contact info are listed below. Okay, Scorpios, enjoy your month of August. Thank you for watching my video, and we'll talk again soon.